Character archetypes is basically a certain expectation atau behavior yang masa kita orang baca atau tengok the story, kita dah kenal dah dia associated dengan siapa. So contohnya, kalau tengok cerita macam English, ada nerd, ada geek, ni semua ada archetype. Kenapa dia orang panggil archetype? Because all these nerd yang label kita orang letak, kita orang ada expect macam mana dia orang akan behave. Tapi what's the difference between character archetype storytelling normal dengan anime character archetype? So dalam anime, dia ada archetype yang unik sikit and ada banyak sebenarnya, tapi hari ni saya nak cakap 5 archetype yang popular dalam anime. First, tsundere. So tsundere sebenarnya dia asalnya perkataan daripada sun-sun dengan dere-dere. So sun-sun ni saya tak pasti the direct translation atau the closest translation, tapi dia macam hostile, dia macam mean atau show or disgust. Dere-dere macam cutesy atau to show of adoration. So dalam konteks ni, usually perempuan tapi laki pun boleh jadi tsundere. Seorang yang awal-awal dia jahat atau dia mean, dia suka acah-acah make fun, acah insult semua tu to the person that they like, tapi as the story progresses, lama-lama dia lagi soft. So ni kita orang panggil tsundere. So boleh bagi banyak contoh dalam konteks anime. Kita orang boleh ambil Shana daripada Shakugan no Shana, Taiga from Toradora, Shitoge from Nisekoi dan banyak lagi. Second, saya nak cakap pasal kudere pula. So kudere, kita orang tahu dah dere maksud apa. So cool dalam kudere ni, dia loosely translated as cool. So macam chill lah. So dalam konteks ni, kudere is seorang yang emotionless atau nampak emotionless dengan tak banyak reaction, tapi as you know them deeper, dia tunjuk dia punya cute side. So contoh dalam anime kita orang boleh tengok adalah macam from Kanade, Angel Beats, Inori Yuzuriha from Guilty Crown, even Rei from Neon Genesis Evangelion. Third archetype yang popular dekat anime is Hime Dere. Hime maksudnya princess. Dalam konteks ni, dalam anime, Hime Dere is seorang yang nak dia punya love interest atau orang in general treat that person like a princess. So kalau perempuan, Hime Dere. Kalau lelaki, Ojo Dere. He wants to be treated like a prince. Kalau Hime Dere, she wants to be treated like a princess. A simple example, kalau korang kenal Vocaloid Hatsune Miku, dia ada satu music video yang tajuk World is Mine, which is basically the depicting, tunjuk straightforward macam mana Hime Dere would behave. Contoh lain daripada anime pula, kita orang boleh nampak Nakiri Erina from Shokugeki no Soma. Archetype yang keempat is Dere Dere. So Dere Dere, dia macam adoration atau macam cute, very cute. Dere Dere, in most animes, this character shows to be very energetic, very enthusiastic and is not afraid to show her emotions towards the main character atau character in general. For example, real anime characters, we know Chiyo from Gekkan Shoujo Nozaki-kun atau we can see Kiwi from Orogeru. And last but not least, one of my favorite Dere is Yandere. So kalau korang pernah tengok anime macam Mirai Nikki atau mungkin Higurashi, korang pernah dengar term ni, Yandere. Yandere dalam konteks ni maksudnya seorang yang sayang or love that particular person to the point of overprotection and in some cases or worst case scenario willing to kill other people, willing to hurt other people in order to protect them. So the most famous example yang notable yang kita orang kenal kalau tengok Gasayuno from Mirai Nikki. Another example, Higurashi, where most of the characters are actually yandere as well. In conclusion, anime has their own interesting and unique expression or unique portrayal of character archetypes. What's important is to know that this is only in fiction and not in real life. So don't confuse reality and real life. That's all from me today. Thank you.